Hello students, welcome back to this second video of transformers of basic electrical engineering. In last video we talk about basics of transformers and EMF equation of transformer. In this video we will discuss about losses in transformer, voltage regulation and efficiency of transformer. Learning outcome of this session are: at the end of this video lecture you will be able to determine voltage regulation and efficiency of a transformer. Losses in transformer. There are mainly two types of losses in transformer: copper loss and core or iron loss. Again, in core or iron loss there are two types: hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. Out of that, copper loss is variable loss and this iron or core loss is the constant loss. So let us see one by one. First is the copper loss. This is due to the flow of current through the conductors of the winding, as these windings are mainly made up of copper. This is an ohmic loss, that is I square R loss. In that, R is the resistance of conductor. In addition to this, there is the loss caused by non-uniform distribution of current density in the conductor. This is all about the copper loss. Now, in core or iron loss, there is the hysteresis loss. This is caused mainly due to the molecular friction of particles of the core, which is normally tend to align themselves in one direction. But as there is the alternating path for these particles, the magnetic flux alternates periodically, this does not changes their path easily, and the power will be lost to align these particles. This variation curve of these particles is known as BH curve, that is flux density and versus magnetic field strength. The larger the value of permeability, the smaller is the loop of that BH curve, and hence smaller the hysteresis loss of the core. Also, hysteresis loss is proportional to the frequency of supply. To minimize such a loss, silicon steel is used as a core material. Second loss is the eddy current loss. The alternating flux due to alternating current flowing through the winding induces voltage in the laminations of the core. The alternating flux due to alternating current flowing through the winding, which induces the voltage in the lamination of the core. This voltage circulates current in the laminations. These currents therefore heat the laminations and result in power loss. Actually, this current is not required to flow in the core, and such a power loss is called as eddy current loss. The eddy current loss is proportional to thickness of lamination. The smaller the thickness, the lower the eddy current losses. This is why the core is laminated so as to reduce eddy current loss. Now voltage regulation and efficiency of a transformer. So let us first see voltage regulation. Voltage regulation of a transformer for a particular load is defined as the change in secondary voltage from the no load to the load under consideration expressed as a ratio of rated voltage of the load. If we consider E2 is the rated secondary terminal voltage and V2 is the secondary terminal voltage for a particular load, then percentage regulation is expressed as E2 minus V2 upon V2 into 100. Keeping primary voltage and frequency is fixed. Now, efficiency of a transformer. The efficiency of a transformer is defined as the ratio of output power to input power, and normally it is denoted by efficiency, is given by output power upon input power. In this equation, we can write input power as a output power plus losses. Again, we can modify that output can be written as input minus losses, and output plus losses can be written as input. So we can write down this efficiency in different forms. Now, direct loading method to determine voltage regulation and efficiency of the transformer. This circuit diagram shows the connection for the direct loading method of transformer. In that, single phase supply is provided to the auto transformer, then ammeter, wattmeter and voltmeter are connected to the primary side, and secondary side is connected to the load with ammeter and voltmeter. This two winding transformer is step down transformer, that means 230 volt is step down to 115 volt. There is a simple method to conduct direct loading method of transformer. First, switch on the supply and apply rated voltage to the primary side of transformer and keep this voltage constant throughout the experiment. That means we have to keep primary voltage as 230 at each reading. Then take down the readings of ammeter, voltmeter and wattmeter connected in primary as well as in secondary circuit at no load condition. First reading is at no load condition. After that, increase the load gradually and take down the reading of all the meters. Take 5 to 6 readings up to full load condition of a transformer. Adjust primary voltage to 230 volt at each reading. Then and then only this method is correct. And by using these readings of primary side and secondary side, we can calculate voltage regulation as well as efficiency of transformer by using formulas which are discussed earlier. Then, auto transformer. What is auto transformer? An auto transformer is one in which one single winding serves as both primary and secondary winding. That means it is a single winding transformer. This figure shows the step up and step down auto transformers. In that, in between A and C, there is the primary voltage, and in between B and C is the secondary voltage. When voltage is applied between, that is primary voltage is applied between A and C, and output is given from between B and C, then such an arrangement is called as the step down transformer. When primary voltage is applied in between B and A, and output is given from A and C, then such an arrangement is called as step up transformer. The winding is divided into two parts, the common winding and the series winding. The common winding is at least a part of both the primary and secondary winding simultaneously, and series winding is separate winding. Now, advantages of auto transformer: less winding material is required than the second two winding transformer, as it consists of single winding. Second advantage is smaller in size as it is single winding transformer, and also cheaper than two winding transformer. As windings are reduced, losses are reduced. As losses are reduced, auto transformer has higher efficiency. Voltage transformer is, voltage regulation is better in auto transformer. An auto transformer has variable output voltage. Applications of auto transformer. Auto transformer is used as a variac in laboratory to use for variable supply voltage. Second is the auto transformer with number of tappings are used for starting induction motors. Thank you.